Hello friends, we'll see today self-introduction, how to give self-introduction. When you go to any new job, even if you want to get promotion, when you want to change your job, you have to face the interview. For every interview, if you are facing the interviewer, if you are going for promotion, every time interviewer first question will be, tell me something about yourself, introduce yourself, speak something about yourself. This is the first question. This is a warm-up question for every HR. When you give your self-introduction, meanwhile, they'll be referring your resume or CV and what are your qualities and what you have done, everything they'll be referring. And at the same time, they'll be seeing your confidence. How you are speaking, how you are presenting about yourself, that is very much important. How do you present yourself? What kind of understanding you are having about yourself? This is the main concept they want to see from yourself. That's the reason they'll ask you to introduce yourself. I'll give you few ideas and what are the areas you have to focus. On that areas, I'm giving you some phrases also. So after hearing this talk, you prepare your self-introduction by yourself. I'm giving you just idea. So after that, you can prepare by yourself. And end of the talk, I'll tell you how to prepare yours and how to rehearsal. All these things I'll tell you. Now let me tell you the main areas where you have to focus for self-introduction. The first thing is that you have to take your name. Before taking the name, always wish the interviewer, good morning sir, good morning madam, whoever is there in front of you. Good morning sir. Thank you very much for shortlisting me for the final interview. Are you able to remember this? Thank you very much for shortlisting me for the final interview. This is one phrase. Another phrase is, thank you very much for giving me wonderful opportunity to introduce myself. Second phrase. Anything you can use it. After that, coming to your introduction. So never say coming to my introduction, coming to my hobbies, coming to my strengths. Don't use this coming. So after using this, wishing and thank you very much for shortlisting me for the final interview. Or thank you very much for giving wonderful opportunity to introduce myself. And after this, coming to your introduction. So what areas you have to focus? First thing is that name. Always take your name by my name is. Please remember this phrase. My name is Mukund. My name is Gayatri. My name is Nalini. My name is whatever is your name. My name is, you can take your name. Please remember, whenever the recruiter or interviewer is saying, good morning Mr. Mukund, introduce yourself. When they are saying, good morning Mr. Mukund, introduce yourself, need not to take your name. It will be a blunder mistake if you take, good morning sir, my name is Mukund, means you have already by hearted. That's the reason you are speaking like this. So that is why never do this mistake. Remember that if they don't use your name, then only go for this. First phrase, my name is so and so. Then after that place, you can talk. You are from which place? I am from Pune. I am from Mumbai. I am from Hyderabad. So I am from, you can say, or I am a native of. I am a native of Hyderabad. I am a native of Madras. I am a native of Nellore. Whatever may be your place, I am a native or I am from. Anything you can say. So these are the first two basic things. After that, you have to speak about your education qualifications. When you have to speak about education qualifications, please remember, need not to speak about your school life, intermediate, 11th, 12th. And if you're having PG degree, don't talk about degree also, not required. And sometimes, like BTech MBA combination is a good combination, then you can speak BTech and MBA. Say I have done BCom, then MCom. Need not to speak about your BCom. Not required, because BCom, after BCom anyway, MCom, it's a flow, on the flow will go. So that is why please speak about your higher education qualifications only. So to speak about your education qualifications, please remember these are the phrases you can use. First one is, I have done BTech. I have done BTech. I have done my BCom. I have done my pharmacy. I have done MBBS. Whatever may be your degree. I have done, with this phrase you can talk. I have done BTech in computer science from Usmania University. Are you able to remember? I have done BTech in computer science from Usmania University. This is one phrase. Second one is, I am a BTech graduate. I am a BTech graduate. I am an MBA postgraduate. Whatever you are having, please put it over there. I'm a BTech graduate in computer science stream with 80% from Usman University, with an aggregate of 80% from Usman University. Please mention about this percentage if you have good percentage, otherwise ignore it. If you want to highlight, if you're having good percentage, then please highlight it by mentioning this second phrase, you can use it. So this is the way to take your education qualification. Please remember, don't speak about your family background. My father is so and so, my mother is so and so, I have siblings of all these stories are not required. It is self-introduction, not family introduction. When they ask you a question, speak about your family, then you can speak. Otherwise, it is not required. Please strictly avoid family background and family details, not required. After education qualifications, speak about achievements. These achievements, you have to recollect what kind of achievements you are having and how can I highlight it, how can I be useful for the organization and what they are expecting. According to that, recollect your achievements and make a match. This is what you have to speak about achievements. Now, simply, I'm giving you idea. What are the achievements? One phrase is here, I won first prize 2 times in paper presentations at where you got it, from which college, which university you got it. That you are mentioning, I won first prize 2 times in paper presentations. Being a student, you might have achieved something. So recollect it and write it. Second one is that I have done crash courses in. Please remember, crash courses are very much important. Simply you have done BTech, simply you have done BCom, simply you have done MCA. It doesn't make much difference. You need to do some crash courses related to your subject outside any good institutions. Crash courses or certification courses, these are going to make the difference between you and other candidates. So that you are mentioning, whatever you have done, saying that I have done crash courses in dash 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 Java, advanced Java, .NET, cloud computing, or embedded system, or financial packages like Tally, whatever you have done. So that you can mention it. I have done crash courses or certificate courses in so and so from which institute, from which place you have done. So that also you can mention it very clearly. This makes a weightage, this gives a good impression on you. Next one, I'm having proficient knowledge. You're having good knowledge. You are having master skills in so and so area. So you can use this phrase, I'm having proficient knowledge in whatever areas, that you can mention it. This is about achievements, and also recollect it, whatever you have achievements, you got awards, rewards, and some milestones in your career. As a student, as an employee, whatever you have, that you can mention it in achievements. Next, project work or experience. If you are a fresher, please go for project work. If you are a fresher, no experience, you can't speak about work experience, then you can speak about project work. For that, what phrase you can use? I have done my project work on, talk about your project work, the title you can say. I have done my project work on, title of the project, at which company. You can just simply say like this. If you have experience, don't talk about project work, not required. Speak about your experience only. No need of project work. How you can speak? Saying here, phrase, I have 5 years rich experience as a dash dash, as a finance man, financial analyst, as a HR, as a software engineer, at which place, which company. So you are saying, I have 5 years rich experience as a at so and so place. This phrase you can use it. And also you can say, my specialization areas are, in which field you are good, you are perfect, that you can say, my specialization areas are dash dash dash, say Java dot or advanced Java, .NET, cloud computing, anything, Python, anything. My specialization areas are, fill up that. So this is the way you have to talk about project work or experience. Next one is that strengths. When it comes to strengths, use 1 or 2 sentences, 1 or 2 phrases very strongly, powerfully, and it has to give the impact on the recruiter. So in that way, select 1 or 2 sentences, more than enough. Now here I'm giving you example. I have strong technical skills in. What is my strength? I have strong technical skills in so and so area. So this I'm mentioning. Or otherwise, non-technically I'm speaking, I'm self-motivated and having zeal in learning new skills. I'm self-motivated and having zeal in learning new skills. Or you can say, I'm a new learner. I always learn new things. I want to learn new things. I'm a team player and also I'm a team leader. So I love to work in a team. Anything. What else you wanted to add? You can just mention its strengths, but speak very confidently. Next one, ambition. Lastly, must you have to mention about your ambition. What do you want to do in your life? Ambition is here. I want to be a strong pillar of any reputed company. I want to be a strong pillar in any reputed company. This is my ambition. Or otherwise, I want to be a respectable position in your organization. I want to be a respectable position in your organization. Or first one, you can say, I want to be a strong pillar of your organization. Second one, you can vice versa, you can do it. I want to be a respectable position in any organization, in any reputed company. Change it whatever you want, but say it your ambition very clearly. After that, that's all from me. Thank you, sir, madam. That's all from me. Thank you, sir and madam. Remember this, all these things need not to follow same to same. Need not to follow is as per the first number. My name is Mukind. I'm from Pune and my education qualifications. I'm a BTEC graduate. My strengths, my experience, like need not to follow. Don't by heart this. Just I'm giving you idea. So what you have, please note down and you can prepare your self-introduction by yourself. Now I'll give you two types of self-introductions, two types of illustrations, how you can give your self-introduction. Shall we go? Now we'll see two introductions, different introductions, phrases and different introductions to people, how they are introducing themselves. So that I'm going to share with you. This is only an example. You can introduce yourself after seeing this introduction. Okay. So the first one is here, a person who is shortlisted for the final interview. So he is introducing himself first, saying that good morning, sir, or good morning, madam. Thank you for shortlisting me for the final interview. Thank you for shortlisting me for the final interview. My name is Rakesh. I live in Mumbai. I have done BE in computer science and MBA in HR. I have 5 years experience as a HR. I'm passionate about perfection of my work. I have strong communication skills with good command over HR policies and training fields for employees. That's all from me. Thank you, sir and madam. He has given a short and cute and very perfect self-introduction. Whatever he wanted to say, he said it very clearly. So if you see this, first of all, he wished and he said thank you also for giving this opportunity for shortlisting him for the final interview. His name and where he lives and his education qualification, BE with computer science and MBA in HR. And also he mentioned about the 5 years of experience. And here I'm passionate about perfection of my work. His nature of job, his nature of work, that he has mentioned, his motto of work also he mentioned in one sentence. I'm passionate about perfection of my work. Then after that, what he said? I have strong communication skills, which is related to the HR. Related to the HR field, he mentioned that I have strong communication skills with good command over HR policies and training field for employees. This is related to the HR. And he has highlighted, I have all the qualities, what you expect for a HR. So that he mentioned and that's all from me. Thank you, sir and madam. That's simple. But very perfect self-introduction he has given. This is one way of introduction. Second illustration. In second illustration, I'm taking a person or a girl whose name already took by the HR. Say like, Miss Shilpa, will you introduce yourself? Now Shilpa is not supposed to say, my name is Shilpa. So second introduction is different without taking the name. Observe. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity. First wishing, good morning sir, good morning madam. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity to express myself. I am young, dynamic and creative professional and engineer graduate. I have profound knowledge in Java, advanced Java and .NET. I am self-driven person. My ambition is to get a job in a reputed company where I can utilize my skills and improve my career path. That's all from me. Thank you, sir and madam. Here, if possible, you can take any kind of strength achievements also if you have. But simply, she has given just two minutes introduction. And coming to the direct point, if you observe, said good morning and saying that thank you for giving this wonderful opportunity to express myself. And she expressed herself like, I'm young, dynamic and creative professional and engineering graduate. Simply not saying I have done BCom, I have done engineering. No, she has mentioned very creatively, saying that she is very confident. And I have profound knowledge in what areas that she has mentioned. And also she mentioned about her nature of work and her motto, personal life, like I'm self-driven person, my ambition is to get a job in a reputed company where I can utilize my skills and improve my career path. That's all. Simple, just 1 minute, 1.5 minute self-introduction, but it gives a very good impact. Please observe this too. Pause the video and observe this. And you can write your self-introduction. As I gave you in the previous slide, few ideas I have given, few praises also I have given, and these illustration also you can see, and write down your self-introduction. Then after that, what you can do is, once if you write, show that your self-introduction to someone and take their opinion, take their advices also. If you miss anything, if you want to add anything, they'll guide you. Then after that, please remember, your self-introduction should not be by-hearted. Stand in front of mirror, remember these points I'm going to give my self-introduction. So what you can do is just practice in front of mirror. Then after that, rehearsal many times you just rehearse it. Then if possible, you can record it. Then you'll have a perfect self-introduction. Then after that also, the rest of the questions, frequently asked questions, also that also you can rehearse it. But this, don't ignore it. First impression you are going to gain with the self-introduction. Hope the talk is useful. In the downside of the description box, I have given a lot of links related to communication skills, body language, job skills, English grammar related. All the links are there in the downside, or you can go to the playlist of this channel. You can find it and improve your skills and forward these videos to someone for whose it is useful, for whom it can be useful. So please take care and improve your career. Keep smiling, keep shining. Good luck.